stop. If you really think that Splinter Cell is like this, you couldn't be more wrong. Because for the average person, the experience is more like...
Young man, there's no need to feel down. I said, young man, pick yourself off the ground. I said, young man, cause you're in a new town. There's no need to be unhappy.
Allow me to start off by saying that if you're one of those people that believe Splinter Cell Chaos Theory isn't the best game in the entire series, you can go ahead and
get the fuck out!
Plot. Basically, you roleplay Sam Fisher, the world's greatest spy that has an obsession with skulking around in the darkness and wearing trinocular green goggles. And let me tell you, this guy does not fool around.
Pick a number between 1 and 10.
What? Oh, crap. 3.
Characters. Apart from yourself, you've got Irving Lambert, your commanding officer, who has an extremely unnerving lazy eye and likes to say your name way too much.
Good job, Fisher. Damn it, Fisher. Good lord, Fisher.
Brim, your tech support, who happens to be the only female in the entire game, which isn't at all surprising. I mean, if Sam Fisher was running around performing his patented butt fist technique against female adversaries in the game, I imagine that Ubisoft would have been swimming in lawsuits 10 years ago. And of course, Admiral Toshiro Otomo, who is so stereotypically Japanese that he's basically an anime character. Just remember that although there are plenty of supporting characters in the game, you have to do figuratively everything by yourself. So get used to having zero backup and basically becoming Jason Derulo.
Solo, I'm riding solo, I'm riding solo, I'm riding solo, solo.
Goggles. I'm not sure how many of you have seen Sam Fisher without goggles on, but he looks like an idiot. An idiot with only two noticeable emotions that I affectionately call Confused Fisher and Suspicious Fisher. For this reason, and this reason alone, you better keep your goggles on at all times, because goggles off is clearly inferior to goggles on.
I've been getting money, where the fuck you been? I've been getting money, where the fuck you been?
Now when it comes to these iconic goggles that outright define the series, you've got three different options. You can night vision, you can thermal vision, or you can electromagnetic vision. Night vision gives you the obvious ability to see in the dark, with the equally as obvious downside of everything looking like an odd combination of light green and black. Just try to imagine lurking under your covers at night while scrolling through pictures of the world's shittiest Instagram filter for 9 hours, and you'll know exactly what night vision is like. Now, although most of you may think that night vision is all you need, that's not necessarily true. Like on the mission Japanese bathhouse, if you try to use your night vision,
I love my eyes!
But if you were to use thermal instead, everything is 10 times easier. That's not to say that thermal vision is necessarily always perfect though. Like if the North Koreans drop the hottest mixtape of 2015, you're gonna have a terrible experience. Light and sound. Although I get that the entire premise of Splinter Cell is a little comical, I mean, if these private military groups were having a real issue with some dude wearing green goggles dragging people into dark corners and murdering them, you'd think they'd just invest in better lighting, but whatever. Seeing as this is a situation that you find yourself in, make every effort to eliminate every possible source of light that you possibly can. Just shoot out lights, blow out candles. Hey, you can even just use a regular old light switch if you want to.
Istanbul police found some guy cut to ribbons. Just
switch that back on. I'm still here.
The game even lets you cheat a little and gives you an indicator in the lower right corner. So if the slider is all the way to the left, people can see you as well as Helen Keller can see a stop sign. And if it's all the way to the right, well, you get the idea. The same goes for sound. If the indicator's all the way to the right, you probably sound like... And all the way to the left is complete silence. Whistle. Now I know, it may not seem like the best idea in the world as a covert agent, but whistling in this game is one of its hallmark features. Yeah. Seriously, you can whistle at people in this game and it's a great way to lure enemies into the darkness. And if they get close enough, you can even start whispering at them.
I like that sound. Who's making it?
You may even get lucky and use the greatest taunt known to man, which of course is the turkey gobble. Yeah, that's an actual feature in the game. I'm not using any kind of clever editing. The world's most highly trained intelligence agent can gobble like a turkey. Fear. The dark isn't just about not being spotted, it's also about putting the fear into your enemies and using all the tactics that I've just explained to you. And I know so many of you are going to say, Sam Fisher isn't even scary, but put yourself in the enemy's shoes. It's all fun and games until a stranger wearing green goggles starts whispering at you in the dark.
Darkness.
Surprise, mother-
Doors! I know that it may sound like a mundane topic, but I've died more times in doorways than I have anywhere else. And when it comes to said doors, you have three options in opening them. You can either open the door regularly, stealth open the door, or my personal favorite, bash the door open and kill anyone on the other side. Just keep in mind that the enemies can do the same thing to you, so I wouldn't recommend fooling around in the bathroom. And last but not least, bottles. Bottles are honestly the most lethal weapon you can possibly use in this game, and it honestly doesn't matter which kind of bottle you're using, whether it's wine or vodka or tequila. Hey, even an empty plastic water bottle will work. Just carefully throw it at the guy's dome piece and...
First blood!
Yeah. That guy actually just died. He's not unconscious, he's straight up dead. I mean, hey, it works if the enemy is sitting down just as well. Yeah, him too. He actually just died. I can even move his body, look. I guess if you're a peasant, you can use other objects like bricks.
Dominating!
Or I don't know, maybe rocks? I realize that I have access to the highest tech weapons and equipment, but who needs that garbage when you have bottles and bricks to throw at people?
There it is. There it is.
Killionaire.
And that's about it. That's all that I have to tell you about Splinter Cell Chaos Theory. I strongly recommend that you try it out, starting out with the original, but just keep in mind that there are absolutely no casuals allowed in this series, and it's not easy. I mean, literally, there is no easy mode in this game. Like, it's not there. There's no option. So if you're looking for a casual stealth game experience, I recommend something like Splinter Cell Blacklist, because that game is garbage.